Well, at the toss for the final, I can tell you that the Lancashire Lightning have won that and they have decided to bat first. Those are the two teams, both sides, in fact, unchanged from their semi-final victories. Let's get to the action.
16 overs aside, Lancashire winning the toss, batting first. Malloy here again. Field very interesting, only two on the leg side. That Somerset plan that we saw in the first semi-final. Only two fielders leg side to Malloy, mid on, and a deep square leg. Andy Caddick to Malloy. You just wonder, Robert, whether we've had a fair amount of weather around, there's been moisture, the pitch has been covered. If this pitch will change at all, what do you think?
It has it greased up. They were pretty quick in getting the covers on, in fairness. But still, you just imagine, it's reasonably humid out there. Is there some dampness that's falling on the pitch that will help the likes of Caddick, Langerfeld and Johnson? We'll wait and see. This new ball, crucial.
There he goes, he's straight to him, he dropped it! Oh, plans are laid, it's Richard Johnson, Malloy with his favourite swipe to leg. Trap's been set and it's down.
You can see the body language. Yeah, at any stage, the chance to win or lose, the game can come, and that can happen in the first or the last over. It's been hit hard, yes, but a comfortable height, and Johnson grasses it. Big pressure. He knows it. Look at his face. He knows it.
What have been doing for half an hour, catching all of them. Get it out of your mind, catch the next.
Good players. They don't need two opportunities, but if you do give them, then very often they capitalise. And often you see good players as well, when they do get that chance, they play with that extra freedom. Lloyd doesn't really need that, but when you give it, it's tough.
Plan set, you can tell. It's the way we've seen Somerset play. Two on the leg side, they know that Malloy gets the ball into that square leg. Might just do a little bit. It might just be a touch with the lights on and moisture around.
There we go, Caddick again doing what Caddick does. A little bit of a way swing, extra bit of nip and zip off the pitch. He looks pumped. Certainly Malloy, we know, will come out there all guns blazing. Somerset team realise what big wicket Malloy is, because he can take the game away from you very early on.
Good pace from Andy Caddick, 84 miles an hour. And he goes again. Keeps it down this time. We've seen that before from Malloy.
I think this is going to end up... Malloy is going to have to name this shot himself at some stage, because we can just keep using it. Uses the pace well. Good hand-eye coordination. Pulls across the line. There it goes. Smears it through mid-wicket. Four runs. He's off and running.
He must have a magnificent eye, because he plays it regularly. It's not just a shot that he plays every now and again. Might just be a field change here. Six without loss in this first over. Smith and Caddick together. That's big. It's straight to him again, Richard Johnson, this time. Two in the same over. One in, one out, Richard Johnson. All that self-doubt out of his mind. Trap's been set again. Malloy might be saying the bat's gone. He's gone.
Terrific bit of cricket. Johnson's recovered. A disastrous drop earlier on in the over. But then look at him, he's redeemed himself. Doesn't he love it? Does he ever? And he's giving the crowd a bit as well.
Reaction there from Andy Caddick and from the Somerset team. That is a big wicket. We've talked forever about the Stars, your Simons, your Flintoffs. That is a massive wicket for Somerset. Malloy's gone for five. Lancashire, six for one in the first over. new batsman's flown out, as he usually does. Andrew Flintoff in at number three. We'll just recap. I've come here for a bit of fun. I want to get into the final. I want to help the team. He's played four matches prior to this. This is his fifth game. Best of 85. Stuart Law will be on strike. Joel Langerfeld, the bowler. With two slips. Taking that from roundabout middle and off. And pumped it through the leg side. Fielding restrictions, just as a reminder, fielding restrictions for four overs. 16 overs a side game.
I think that the Lancashire team have done their homework here. They know the style of play with a 7-2 offside field that Somerset use. And there you see Stewie Law shuffle across to the offside and flick him through mid-wicket. Now is a change in the field. Deep square has gone back.
Langerfeld will swing the ball if there's anything there in these sort of conditions. And I don't know, it's just a theory, but the lights are on, there's been some moisture around, it's still early evening. I'm not saying it's warm, but it's not breezy either. Pitch has been covered. Might just help swing and seam bowling.
I think the best way to describe it as we've walked across there was muggy. And I think with the water we've had there, the rain we've had, there's a bit of swing, gives it a bit of extra assistance. These lights, for some reason, it helps it swing. That's a wide ball there. But from a bowling point of view and a captain's point of view, at least it's doing something for the bowler, which is dangerous, which can help you take those early wickets, which I'm sure that the Somerset team will identify. They want to get stuck into this Lancashire middle order as early as they possibly can.
Just one wide and one no ball in Somerset's semi-final. There is a little bit of swing. A bit of greasy in the outfield as well for the fielders. Ian Blackwell down there at third man. 16 over a side, fielding restrictions for four overs. One bowler can bowl four overs, four bowlers can bowl three. Still a terrific crowd in here at the Brit Oval. Flintoff, first delivery, and just a little push to mid on. I'm sure the crowd, well, certainly been very patient with many rain interruptions today. Thankfully, it's not absolutely poured down. But you can see there are plenty of people still in, lots of youngsters. It's been terrific walking around the ground and all these youngsters with smiling faces and enjoying the day. Outside the line, comfortably outside the line.
There's that plan again from Stuart Law. Sees the 7-2 offside field, realises there's plenty of open spaces on the leg side. He shuffles across, makes sure that he gets outside the line. Looking to work it into the leg side, as we can see, well outside the line. Never going to be LW from there.
Just get a single. Two overs gone, 15 for one. Lancashire, 15 for one after two overs. 16 over a side game. Graeme Smith, as ever, pumped up for the game. Keen as mustard. Caddick in the air, who wants it? Ian Blackwell's underneath it. He's called it. They're going to collide. Blackwell gets it. Safe pair of hands. What a big wicket that is.
They're eyeing up this leg side. Stuart Law did it the previous over. The 7-2 offside field. They see an open gaps on the left on the leg side. He shuffled across, just lined up a bit, just seamed towards the offside, caught the leading edge, and Blackwell, he wants it. He knows he's got a safe pair of hands, gets under there early and takes the catch. Fantastic wicket. Andrew Flintoff's on his way back.
Richard Johnson was on collision course as well. It was Blackwell in the end that took the catch. He does have a safe pair of hands. Andrew Flintoff dismissed for two. just be able to speak to Ian Blackwell here. David Lloyd upstairs, Ian.
Hi, Bumble.
Well, what a start that is.
Well, we'll take that. That came down with snow on it as well, just quietly.
And what about this cunning plan to Mal Loy leg side?
Well, I knew he'd pick up Caddy's length, but we persisted with a 7-2 field, but I'm pretty happy with a 6-3, but it seemed to work for us.
Stuart Law and Andrew Simons out there in the middle for Lancashire Lightning. Two down, one of them Flintoff, the other one Mal Loy. Andy Simons, Lancashire need a big innings from him. Offside this time, one bounce. Engelfeld down at third man.
Certainly seems to be zipping off the pitch now. In fairness, Andy Caddick's tail is up. He's just taken out Andy Flintoff. So you're never going to be happier. But he's coming in with real intent. Stewie Law to keep playing his way. But in fairness, Langefeld was up to it. Superb stop.
Andy Simons, 52 in 30 balls in the semi. 2 for 7, Caddick. Dealing down to third man again to Langefeld down there. Well, you can see it in the players' eyes and the body language that there is no hiding place out there. Every delivery is coming to you, whether you're at deep square leg or at third man or at mid-off. Deep in concentration here. Quite happy just to give that single away in the offside. Always looking to save the boundaries.
I think with the start they've had, I think that's they're saying now they have a little bit of damage limitation in the first four overs. They've taken the singles, but maybe a touch early to tell. But in your opinion, this four-hour layoff, has it caught the Lancashire team a little bit cold?
They were out there for a long time practicing. Another excellent over from Andy Caddick, 18 for 2. Well, they were out there practicing. They went through the similar routine. They looked very relaxed. They're going to play shots, and Mal Loy is certainly going to play shots. Flintoff, we all know about Andrew Flintoff, but it was Andy Caddick who just nipped in with those two wickets. Two overs, 2 for 9 for Andy Caddick, and it's just a decent time to bowl this for me, just as a night time is drawing in, the lights are on. Yeah, you got it right. We walked across, it was muggy. There's a dampness about the atmosphere out there. Lancashire 217 in the semi-final. I don't think it's going to be that way in the final here. But a change of bowling, and Richard Johnson takes over from Langefeld.
I think communication is key here. You've got two very experienced batsmen out there, and as you mentioned, not every wicket is a 200 wicket. What they've got to do is back themselves to communicate with the rest of their team what they think is a competitive score. Now, that could be 130, it could be 140, or on different surfaces, it could be 180, 190. But they've got to really back their judgment here and decide as a team what they think is going to be the best score.
Wide down the leg side. Well, just look at that second semi-final where 157 was Somerset's first innings, and Graeme Smith saying we didn't think that would be enough, but it turned out to be just enough. We might see totals on a par with that. I know it's only a 16-over game, this, but 157 saw Somerset home. Stuart Law down the ground, long chase for Andy Caddick, he won't get there.
Well, Stewie Law is keeping playing in a positive vein. Johnson's just come into the attack and he wants to impose himself on Johnson as early as possible. Here he advances down the wicket, doesn't quite get out of the sweet spot of the bat, but gets enough on it, goes straight for four. Nothing that Andy Caddick could do about that.
The single. Might just have a chat with Graeme Smith if we can, just when he sets this field here.
Yeah, David, I got you. Langers! Langers!
Langers, for goodness sake, listen. Terrific
no
start, Graeme.
I have no voice by the time I'm 26, I'm telling you.
Graeme, terrific start.
Yeah, a terrific start. I just need one more, yeah, one or two more. Come on.
Boundary ball. Ball of full length from Richard Johnson. Andy Simons with a crisp boundary.
He's gone for the Yorker and he's just got it back of length again. And with the powerful forearms that Simons has got, he powers it down past mid off for four runs. But I wonder if the Somerset guys are missing a trick here. And we've seen that the ball is nipping around and swinging a bit. Surely now, length top of off, the way it's swinging, to take Simons out here at this stage is really important.
Well, Graeme Smith just said it, we could do with another two quickly. You're never satisfied, of course, as a captain, when you nip two out, you put a side under pressure, get big players in, and they've got big players in now. That helps Lancashire's cause. Simons rides his luck, over the slips.
Somerset will be reasonably happy with the way that Lancashire are approaching this because they are giving them a chance to pick up wickets. He's backed away, got it too high for the slip to take on there, four runs, but rather hectic, rather frantic start here. And, you know, as Graeme Smith just pointed out, two wickets, four down, they're really in the hunt.
That's it, his partner, Stuart Law. At the non-striking end, that's the end of the fourth over, that's the end of the fielding restrictions. It's a 16 over a side game, this. Richard Johnson, his first over going for 15. 33 for two, Lancashire Lightning, batting first. And we talk about big players, there's a big two out there. Stewie Law and Andrew Simons. Dominic Court to come. Captain Chilton, Chappell, Crook, Hegg, Anderson, Keady.
There's a third, put Caddick into that. Two overs, two for nine. This is going to be a battle royal. Caddick versus Simons. They realise they've battled against each other many times in the past. But Simons knows that Caddick is the danger man here. Can he afford to play loosely? Has he got to play with the real, real sense of responsibility for his team?
It's extraordinary that fielding restrictions have been relaxed, but there's still two slips in there. Caddick has bowled very, very well. Just wonder how long those slips will be in for. Two catches. Graeme Smith again, go back to what he said, we need another wicket quickly.
Well, that tells me two things from up here. That tells me that the pitch is doing a lot more than it was earlier on. They have confidence in the ball doing something off the wicket, hence giving catches. And also the fact that they're hunting down that middle order of Lancashire. They see that as a possible soft underbelly and they want to expose it as quick as they can.
Stuart Law just playing sensible cricket. I think if Stuart Law and Simon set the stall out to bat the 16 overs, it's unlikely they'll lose a wicket, won't they, somewhere along the way. But what they'll be trying to do, in theory, set your stall out, we bat, we get a big score.
Would you look, if you were Andy Simons now, to play Caddick out?
He can bowl four overs, Andrew Caddick. I think they've got to back themselves to go after him in sensible areas. For instance, if he bowls back of a length and it sits up nicely and you've got a bit of width, you've got a scoring opportunity, a boundary ball. Now, whether you say, OK, we're going to go after Caddick and give him everything, kitchen sink him, might not be sensible. Perhaps wait until he gets out of the four overs, say he's gone for 30. I think you've probably done your job. Caddick's on 2 for 12 right now. Cheeky. No fielder down there.
Yeah, he's just got his length, slightly his line wrong there. I think if the length had been just a little bit fuller, it'd be difficult to get around to that corner. But 7-2 field, which has paid off earlier on, has helped claim two wickets, has yielded four runs on that occasion.
Fine legs dropping back now, they'll make a change. That's the thing that we would talk about. Andrew Caddick has a natural length and it is back of a length. They do play against each other often. They know the styles of play, know the styles of the bowlers. Just he's kept a slip in, he's still got one slip. Chai at the stumps, he's hit. Now they fancy this, Somerset. Third umpire will be in. It's a direct hit. And you know what you know about direct hits, they're usually out.
Body language in the face of Andrew Symons thinks he's close. Terrific work by Durston, and that looks gone.
Well, Lancashire now, spectator-wise, close your eyes if you're of a nervous disposition. Third umpire gives his decision. Brilliant piece of fielding. Wesley Durston takes aim, fires, and the stumps are down.
Terrific cricket. Durston comes to the party. Caddick, ball a good length and line there. Call for the quick single and terrific work as we talk about the practice that these guys do. Look at him. He's confident. A terrific throw. Got into balance very quickly and he's taken out Symons and they've done exactly what they wanted to get into this middle order as early as possible.
Andy Symons has gone for 12. Enter Dominic Cork. We've talked about 2020 all season, all last season and the season before, and you talk about stars, the big players. Suddenly you see Carl Gazzard in the semi-final, man of the match. Wes Durston, what a great piece of fielding that is to get rid of the big player, Andy Symons. Corky's out there. Five overs have gone. Lancashire 41 for three. And Cork will be looking to disturb Somerset here. There's no doubt. Where's Durston there? Let's have a look at this piece of fielding.
There he goes. He picks it up. Quick feet. Balances up quickly and terrific throw. Right on the money. Here we go. Just watch and admire. There he gets in. Quick to release. One bounce straight in, hits the leg stump.
Terrific skill from the young lad. Get Andy Caddick, the old stager as well. Finals day. Andy Caddick with 2 for 17 from his three overs. Richard Johnson starts his second over. Little bit of movement, just a touch. Now watch Dom Cork here. He'll try to disturb him. Get right under the skin if he can.
That's what he'll try and do. But good move from Smith, keeping two slips in there. Dominic Cork plays with a slightly open face and with the sideways movement that Richard Johnson seems to be getting now. Those two slips are waiting. Four down, key.
That's why you've got two slips in there. Truscothic, safe hands. At first slip, Graeme Smith, hatching plans left, right and centre, and they're all paying off.
Yep, superb bit of cricket. The wicket has changed, it is swinging. Dominic Cork with that open face, he can't resist trying to run it down to third man. And Truscothic, as he usually does for England, pouches another one. And Johnson, look at that smile.
Don't mention catches for England, we'll talk about that another time. Cork's gone for one, 41 for four. Glenn Chappell is the new batsman. Graeme Smith said right at the very top, try to get into this middle order. I think they've got a long tail, is what he said. Stuart Law is still out there on 18 from 14 deliveries. Glenn Chappell, more than useful as a batsman. And again, a very experienced cricketer for Lancashire. Well, he's got Wayne to do, work to do here. I'm looking at Wayne Larkin's there. He likes Oasis, Manchester group. He's enthusiastic about his football, I can tell you that. No good, just enthusiastic. Gone, first ball, Glenn Chappell. He's on a hat-trick again, Richard Johnson. The big boys, the big shots of 41 for 5.
Yep, what a terrific effort by Johnson. He's just taken out Cork. Chappell's come to the crease, but he's still on the money. Johnson, Richard Johnson, with the aid of an inside edge, takes out Glenn Chappell. Fantastic bit of bowling. Look at that, nice and full. Inside edge drags it on. And now they are 5 down. And just look, that smile is getting wider and wider.
Well, Somerset absolutely full of it. They were outsiders for the 2020 final winners. Got through the semis. Bat's gone in the corner of the dugout. Worst feeling of all time. He's on a roll, Graeme Smith, absolutely. Plans are working. Applauds his team, urges his team on. And Richard Johnson, once again, on a hat-trick. Two slips in the 2020 final.
Get another one in there.
Single to Chilton. Chilton, Lancashire's captain. Lancashire's opening batsman. Slips in down the order in 2020. You've never seen bigger smiles on the faces of Somerset's players. Somerset spectators also made the journey into the big city. Graeme Smith, he may be leaving after this game. Go back to international duty with South Africa. And he still kept his slip in there. A lot rests on Stewie Law now. Watch wickets fall all around him. Open the batting. 19 from 15 deliveries. He's only been in for 15 deliveries. Only faced 15 deliveries, Stewie Law. 43 for 5. I just had a hunch before the toss that the atmosphere and the weather and the lights might just change it, might do a bit with a new ball. Taking Caddick on this time at mid-on. Home safely. Richard Johnson, 2 for 18.
Terrific over for his team, Richard Johnson. First game all season. Here he comes, the first. What a great delivery, kept the two slips in there, just nipping away, and Dominic Cork obliged. And this one, a wide length ball which was dragged on. Yeah, a little bit of luck involved in that, but he bowled enough good deliveries beforehand.
His first over went for 15. So he had 2 for 3 in his second over there. He's having a game, isn't he? Dropped Malloy in the first over at square leg, then took the catch. Caddick's last over. 3 overs at 2 for 17, and he's still got 2 slips in.
Well, he's going for the throat now, Smith. He's kept Caddick on to bowl his 4 overs out.
So he's bowled, or he's into his 4th over, so it's one bowler can bowl 4. 4 bowlers can bowl 3 overs. That's where Lancashire are so far, winning the toss, batting first. 45 for 5. It's a 16 over a side match, is the final. Had one or two rain delays. The ball well as Caddick, hasn't he?
He's done well. He's a real confidence bowler. We all know over the years the wickets that he's taken for Somerset. A tremendous bowler he's been for Somerset and England. And certainly coming into this environment today, he's one of those big match players who's got the game that could win the game for Somerset. And in the final, he's shown everybody what he can do. And Graeme Smith sees him as the man now. He's bowling him out with his 4th over. He's going for the throat.
Burston again. Don't run to him. We might just be able to have a chat with Graeme Smith again. Graeme, have you got me?
Yeah, I got you.
You're on fire, mate.
Bowler's on fire. I saw it in Keddie's eyes, he wanted it, this is what he's made for.
All the plans are going to absolutely bang on, aren't they?
I was hoping Kerry's on.
He looks like he's enjoying it down there.
There is a fine leg in position now. Graeme, what did you think about Johnson when he dropped that catch first up in the first over?
I didn't panic too much. I was quite happy with the way he played. You know, he kind of gave us a chance from the start, and our plan kind of paid off. So yeah, I can't moan now.
Somerset have still got to really concentrate here because there are two out-and-out batsmen still out there, two very experienced players, the captain and Stuart Law, who've played lots of innings for Lancashire, been in this situation before and dug Lancashire out of it. So Somerset have got to stay on their mettle.
That'll be the end of Andrew Caddick's spell. And what a spell it's been. Four overs, 2 for 21 in the final.
He's been superb. He's a big match player. As Smith just said there, he could see it in his eyes from early on. You can see his wickets. Just had him put down the over before, and there it is. Similar sort of position. Andy Flintoff looking to work it into the mid-wicket area, sorry. Catches the leading edge. Great take.
Got a change of bowler. Keith Parsons, medium pace, comes into the attack. Wicketkeeper up to the stumps, Carl Gazzard. Three overs for 15 in the semi-final for Keith Parsons. Be very interesting watching Stuart Law play out this innings. Wickets falling around him. What does he do? I think what he tries to do is bat the 16 overs. He's got so much experience. Yeah, he's just telling Mark Chilton that there's a little bit of swing, nothing more. It's gentle swing. And here's Smith again. Truscothick goes to slip for that open face.
That's smart cricket again. Work the singles, work the gaps, get themselves back into a position with four overs left and hopefully five wickets to use in that time. I think anything they can, if they can claw their way up to 120, they've got a chance, but they need to get to 120.
No, just a single here. Somerset just have to keep an eye on the clock. Less than 27 minutes remain in this innings. There are 60 minutes allowed for them to bowl their overs. We're not halfway through yet. Mind you, five wickets have fallen. It'll be a wide. Good work from Gazzard. He's had a good day.
Certainly has. Man of the match in the first semi-final. And sure, not an easy take when it goes down the leg side. Two hands, and he's got the speed of thought to go back to the stumps as well.
When will Ian Blackwell come into the attack and just take the pace off? Left arm spin.
I think he's got to get him on as soon as possible for two reasons. He's a wicket taker, and two, that he needs to speed up the over rate.
And Blackwell down there at third man. 54 for 5, Lancashire Lightning. Nearly halfway through the innings. $54 for 5. 54 for 5. Here's Nasser Hussain and Ian Ward.
Thank you, Bumble. Lancashire Lightning under pressure. Ian Blackwell into the attack from the pavilion end. Blackwell bowled beautifully in the first semi-final against the Leicestershire Foxes. 3 for 25 for Blackwell. Law's got away with it. Coming down the wicket, looking to drive down the ground. He's thick-edged it. He's running away to the boundary. It's a great effort, but it's ultimately futile. And Law has another boundary.
Well, still some hope for Lancashire Lightning. These are two quality players, Stuart Law, Mark Chilton. Law likes to go offside to the left arm, spinner over extra. Gets an edge, Langeveld, sparing, dive, hits his body, goes for four.
Refusal from Blackwell. Goes immediately to the footholds to just dust his fingers with some soil. It will be greasy. Greasy outfield. Again, Law looking to go on the offside. This batting performance from the Lightning, Nass, have they been at fault or have Somerset bowled well?
You have to give credit to Graeme Smith, you have to give credit to Andrew Caddick, Richard Johnson. I think they bowl really well. Smith kept his slip fielders in, good captaincy from him. Stuart Law again. Does it once, annoys Blackwell, does it twice. Both times you get four runs. Still plenty of cricket left in this game.
The frustration was just etched all over Ian Blackwell's face. The second time in the over that he's defeated Law in the flight. A really qualified Englishman has managed to squeeze it away to the third man boundary. No slip for Blackwell. Yeah, I've been impressed with Graeme Smith's captaincy throughout this 2020 finals day. He's encouraging them, firing them up, but he's seems to be able to keep his own head, keep a cool head, keep thinking clearly.
Yeah, while he's doing that, he's capable of reading other people's heads, such as Andrew Caddick. He worked out Andrew Caddick was fired up. He bowled him his full quota. Now he'll have to read how this partnership's going. Ian Blackwell just bowled his first over. One over for nine. They'll also have to get round. They are a little bit slow because they've gone seam up and they've got wickets, so they're going to be a little bit slow. One person who'll be watching the spinners, I'd guess, though, Ian, is Andrew Simons, because he'll have to decide whether he's bowled seam up or spin. So far under these lights, it's swung around. So Andrew Simons, that versatile cricketer, when it comes to Lancashire having a bowl, he might bowl seam up, depending on conditions.
Oh, a majestic shot from Stuart Law. He'll just get one to Hildreth on the boundary. You were his captain, would you be offering any words of advice? I'd sooner him, shouldn't he be doing this, that or the other?
Yeah, at the moment I'd say seam up is the way to go. They'll have a look at Keady, see if he's turning it, and then Andrew Simons will decide. Oh, that would have been a little bit of a death for Stuart Law, backing up there. If the bowler had got something onto that, they come back for two. And a little partnership's building, 25 of 23 deliveries. These are two proper batsmen. That's the thing that Lancashire still have going in their advantage. Chilton opens the batting in four-day cricket. Stuart Law is a world-class player. And in 16 overs, Ian, if you do lose wickets early, it's not as much of a problem as, say, 20, because you don't have that much time to regroup.
Come on, Barso! Come on, guys!
Parsons, a wily campaigner with both bat and ball, just wobbling it around under these conditions. Ryan Smith, keep looking at him, perpetual motion, always cajoling, directing, encouraging and sometimes criticising. He had a bit of a go at Richard Johnson for allowing Stuart Law to scamper back for two. He's bang up for this, the Somerset captain.
You said he felt he was a little bit tired at the toss for the final. He looked tired.
He did, he came wandering out. He was about 12 yards away, 20 yards away rather, and he said to one of the umpires, oh dear, this two games in one day is a bit much. I think he was talking more about the mental side of things. He's so up for the game, and then to go away and sit down and wait and watch it rain and fire yourself up again, that is difficult. And that's what you were saying, you've got some quality players at the crease. You've got Mark Chilton and Stuart Law. Stuart Law, 35, not out. What about the men to come for the Lancashire Lightning? Crook, Hegg, Anderson and Keady. So at what point do these two really start hitting the accelerator, bearing in mind what's coming later? Can they afford to lose a wicket here now?
No, they can't. I mean, six overs is not a lot, but they... A partnership is the absolute key. These two need to keep going for as long as possible. Not panic too easily, because although Crook and Hegg can bat, they won't be able to score as well as these two are now established. Stuart Law, 31 deliveries, Chilton, 11. They mustn't go too early. If they post a score, you never know.
Absolutely beautiful. What a delivery from Ian Blackwell. We've seen him find the outside edge of Stuart Law's bat. He's raced away for fourth. A little bit straighter here to Chilton. Found a little bit of turn. And it's defeated the Lightning captain, Ian Blackwell. Well bowled.
Well, Andrew Simmons, he might have to bowl spin because this pitch is middle, hits top of off. Ian Blackwell is having a very good finals day. He's a quality cricketer, Ian Blackwell. Really uses his brain when he's bowling, and that was a beauty. Classic left armer's dismissal. Chilton goes for nine. Lancashire 69 for six.
Ian, it's Wardy in the commentary box. You got me?
Yeah, I have, mate, yeah.
Very well bowled. The left arm Murulitharan by that one. That turned a bit.
Yeah, a little bit of grip, which is always nice from round the wicket. It just gives me an option to bowl more attacking lines, I guess.
Bit of turnout there for you?
Yeah, a little bit of grip, but the ball is quite hard to hold on to at the moment. Keeps getting wet off the grass, so...
A little bit of juice still there?
There is a bit, yeah.
I'll let you go. Thanks for talking,
mate,
to
cheers.
Us.
See what I mean about him, though, Ian? He knows his game. Come round the wicket, he understands his game. He's got quite a good cricket brain on him for a left-arm spinner.
Spoken like a true batsman. As I say, he's certainly having a good 2020 finals day. Bang up for it. With the advent of the new rules and the 50-over internationals, one-day internationals, the super subs, will he come back into the thinking now?
Well, I'm sure his name came up this summer with the NatWest Challenge. I'm sure his name was in the equation. There are other things that go with Ian Blackwell that might have kept him out of the England setup. Really go into him now, but if he can sort out a few problems, then I think his name will keep popping up, and performances like this, he's got a chance.
Beautifully placed from Stuart Law. He will come back for two, and he will get there. End of the 11th over, 74 for six. Four or six, the Lancashire Lightning. Our games change in such a short space of time. They were absolutely creaming it to the boundary against the Surrey Lions in the first semi-final. Everybody hitting big, powerful boundaries. They're scrapping here.
Oh, he can't be.
Well, they're in uncharted territory. It's your worst nightmare. You play one way leading up to the final. Your whole game plan's gone right. Every game... And you get to the final, and all of a sudden, it is plan B. It probably isn't even plan B now, it's plan F. 74 for six, the big guns have gone.
Ready?
Collision, Stuart Law crashes in to Crook, and he didn't look best pleased. We've all done it. We've all done it as batsmen. Happens to the best. Oh no, where are you going? Interesting statistic here, Nas. Six of Lancashire's eight wins in this 2005 2020 have come batting first. So you talk about the game plans that they have, A, B, C, D, and you're getting down to F. They've really not had to go to B or C until this part of the competition.
I bet they've never been 76 for six in any of those games. Good bowling. Parsons mixing it up really well. You have to post a score. You never know. Post a score, get maybe 110, you've got a chance. 120 would be brilliant.
Well bowled. Two runs from that Keith Parsons over. 12 overs gone, 76 for six. Remind you that this isn't a 20-over aside contest. You're just joining us. Rain has intervened. It's a 16-over aside encounter. So four overs to go. This is the story of the Lancashire Lightning innings. They won the toss, they decided to bat. It hasn't gone their way. Stuart Law, the one man to stand up in these conditions. The ball has nipped around a little bit, but Somerset have been bang on their game. 76 for six. Two for Caddick and two for Richard Johnson. Law's placed it perfectly again. He'll scamper back for two and he'll get there comfortably.
That's his area to the left-arm spinner. He goes in to out, gives himself plenty of room, goes over extra through cover point. He's got over half the runs, 42 out of 78 runs, Stuart Law. Needs to be there right at the end.
Great shot. Beautifully timed and wonderfully placed. Two men scampering round were Hildreth and Johnson. They had no chance of cutting that off. A quality stroke from Stuart Law. And he's moving on to 46.
First boundary for four overs. Dead square on the leg side. No one there apart from a steward. That's the projected. Nine and over, 115. That possibly is their target.
You say Stuart Law likes to go offside in that area that we've just seen him pick that single up, extra cover. Possibility of Blackwell going over the wicket to him, changing the line.
He could do. I think he'll definitely stay around the wicket to Crook. I believe he thinks he can get Crook out. He is with over the wicket, round the wicket. When a batsman first comes in, I think it's better to come round the wicket, try and get him out. When he gets in, like Stuart Law's in now, possibly to bowl over the wicket. Also, tail enders come round the wicket. They don't like it so much. Spinning. Still struggling holding that ball, Ian Blackwell. That's why this has been a magnificent spell. 2.4 overs, one for 22 with a damp ball. He's still got it to turn.
Ian Blackwell has one delivery left. That'll be his three-over allocation done and dusted. One for 23 at the moment. Keith Parsons is also bowled out. A few options for Captain Smith. Transpire in the next few minutes. Big shot. Hildreth is the man fielding out there in the gloom. And he does well. End of the 13th over. 86 for 6. Charles, who have you got down there?
Well, I'm down here in the Lancashire dugout with the coach, Mike Wilkinson. Three overs to go. What are you going to be happy with now, Mike?
I think from this situation, if we can get 110, 115, then it'll be some runs on the board. Guys will have to bowl well, catch well and put some pressure on them.
Do you think the conditions have changed markedly because of that little rain burst before the final got underway?
It probably has. The guys are saying the ball's just holding in the wicket a little bit longer. We've seen Caddy swing the ball, so maybe there's something in there for our guys as well.
And the other thing is, of course, the outfield's quite damp, isn't it? Which probably means that the ball's not just running away quite as quickly as it was earlier in the day.
No, you don't know whether that's going to work for or against you, because the ball gets wet, but it also slows it down in the outfield. But
this could be a trouble. Let's back out of the commentary box. Oh, he's dropped it.
He didn't want that in the human.
Keith Parsons was the man desperately looking around for somebody else to come and take that catch. It went miles up into the night sky. Very difficult to catch cricket balls under floodlights. And Parsons, well, he made a good fist of it, but he was never getting anywhere close to getting right underneath that, grasping at thin air. Oh, and he nearly got cleaned up when the ball bounced back past his chin. Chance of third man, Blackwell won't make it. Sprawling effort, he's done very well. They're going to scamper back for two. Blackwell initially made the positive decision to try and make the catch. Always difficult down there on the boundary. He's charged forward, not made it, but he's done well to stop four.
All good thinking from Blackwell, thinking on his feet. couldn't take the catch, stopped the boundary, saved two runs. Excellent work. Moves on to eight. He's had two chances in two deliveries, well, a half chance. Ian Blackwell. Bring Stuart Law back on strike. With two and a bit overs left, I think Lancashire would like to see Law on strike. He can be the man who takes them to that score of 115 that their coach was talking about. So 48 from 38 deliveries.
That target that Mike Watkinson was on about, do you think that's enough?
You never know in a final, under lights. Will be his 50. He's gone over mid-wicket, a couple of bounces, mid-wicket comes round, he misses it. It's four runs to Stuart Law, 50 in the final. And all around him was losing their head. Stuart Law kept his. He's played really well. 52 off 39 deliveries. He's given Lightning just a sniff, nothing more.
Wonderful talent, Stuart Law. Scored runs all around the world. Prolific for Essex, prolific for Lancashire, prolific for Queensland. And he's doing it now for Lancashire, under pressure in the final. And a one-man band, 52 not out for Stuart Law out of a total of 95 for six. Fielded. Well fielded. Keith Parsons in the end did well to hang on to that. End of the 14th over the Lightning, 95 for 6. Well, we've been blessed. Seen some wonderful cricket today. Some wonderful cricket shots. None better than some seen here by Stuart Law. Wonderful improvisation. Somerset set some imaginative fields. Didn't have fine leg for the seamers. Counteracted that by going across his stumps and flipping it down the leg side. It was a boundary that took him to his 50 this morning. Matt Wood couldn't cut that off. 52 not out from 41 balls all around the wicket. No area not used. Two overs to go. Johnson back into the attack.
Well, it's gone high up again. He's chipped it over mid-wicket and it's got over and he'll come back for two. But really playing that chip shot pretty well. Moves on to 11. 27 for six. Slower ball from Johnson. He's bowled really well at the death of both innings so far. Yorkers and slower balls. This will be a crucial over for Richard Johnson.
Big slice over backward point. Wood won't get that. The highest partnership of the innings now between Crook and Law. 11-4 of the Lightning innings.
All valuable runs. Brings up the 100. Remember what Gazzard did in the last semi-final. Everyone thought, ah, oh, that's just a few boundaries at the end. How crucial they were. An hour or so's time, will they be looking back thinking, these runs from Crook have won us this game. It's gone straight up. Someone's got to catch it eventually. Gazzard calls his name with the gloves on. He does the work. Good catch.
Never an easy catch under lights, particularly when they go straight up in the air. And I don't care that he's got keeping gloves on. That was a good catch. The ball went a long way up. Big top edge from Crook, spiralling into the night sky. He positioned himself well underneath it, Carl Gazzard, and made no mistake. Johnson's delighted. He's got his third wicket, 3 for 24. He's on now. And Andrew Crook has to go. Lightning 101 for 7. Crook back in the pavilion, or the dugout, for 15.
Nine balls left in the innings. Stuart Law now on strike. The batsman in his last season at Lancashire, Warren Hegg. He's been round forever, played for Lancashire, played for England. Boy, would he like to go out with a trophy.
Scampered single. And they'll get two, but Warren Hegg's overrun it. Warren Hegg desperate to get down to the danger end. Just couldn't stop in time to turn around. The shy from Triscothic. Johnson couldn't hold on to it. Just one run to Stuart Law. Egg's job here, Nass. Get Law on strike.
Well, either that or get 30 off the last 10 deliveries or 8 deliveries without taking any risks. He does go offside. That's not the way to go, Warren. Been round long enough. It's hard enough to hit a ball just standing in front of the stumps when you're 4 yards away from the stumps. Virtually impossible. Went really early, exposed his stumps. Good bowling, Richard Johnson. He's been so impressive at the end of an innings. Really has. Been out of cricket for a while, injured. Right on the money at the death of an innings.
Wants to play down the ground. It'll just be a single. That's the end of the 15th over. 103 for 7. Final over to be bowled of this Lightning innings. Warren Hegg has found the gap. Has he found the boundary? Yes, he has. Great shot. Just what was required at this stage. They need boundaries, they need runs. And off the first ball of the final over, they've got a boundary.
Well, Warren Hegg is a slicer of a cricket ball. Very, very much an in-to-out player. Favours the offside, favours extra cover. Done that a few times in his career. He's won Lancashire some crucial games, some crucial semi-finals, finals. Some experience in there. Mustn't back away too much, though. Well bowled.
Oh, that was well bowled. Just a hint of in-swing as well. Charlotte Langefeld. Nearly hit that off stump. Just drifting in at the end. Very difficult to score off that in any form of the game.
We have a bit of a theory. Somerset, they should open with Triscothic. Wardy, is that right?
Definitely think it's an option. He squeezed that out onto the offside. Yeah, I just thought it was an option. You know, Marcus Triscothic, England's opening batsman in both forms of the game. Prolific scorer for England in one-day cricket as an opener. It's a big high-pressure game. The conditions are perhaps favouring the bowlers, the seamers with the new ball. You get the man best equipped to deal with that. Out in the middle, first up. Deal with a new ball. Deal with Flintoff. Deal with Anderson. You're not quite so sure, though. Am I right, Ness?
I see Stuart Law hit that. That's just gathered speed off the outfield. The skiddy outfield. Stuart Law has timed that beautifully. Another boundary in that area through extra cover. Nothing wrong with the delivery. Possibly should have gone Yorker, dragged it down, and Law put it away. 57 or 43 deliveries. Anything I'd say is just, you're in a final. They've got here with Wood and Smith getting him off to flyers. It would be just dangerous to change away from that theory in a final. Stick to what you know. Having said that, you're spot on. Conditions are swinging on a ground that Marcus plays very well at. Double 100 in the test match. 100 against Bangladesh, it definitely would be an option.
Straight down the ground from Law. Caddick will get round and cut it off, but he can't stop the two, so Law will be back on strike for the final delivery of the Lightning innings. 114 for 7. Oh, they're up near and around what Mike Watkinson, the Lancashire coach, was hoping for when Charles was interviewing him in the dugout. Something to bowl at. Anderson, Simons, Flintoff have runs on the board. Can they pressurise Somerset? Last ball. Swing and a miss. Hey, what doesn't want to run? Law's run out. What a terrible, tragic end to Stuart Law's innings. He's played so well. He's held this Lancashire Lightning innings together single-handedly. 59 out, run out off the last ball. Nothing he could do about it. Had to try and look for the run. Just didn't work for him. 16 overs. 114 for 8. And a sorry demise for someone who's played so well.
Yeah, very fine innings from Stuart Law. Held it all together for Lancashire. And if they go on to win this game, they'll thank that man. 59 of 45 deliveries, coming into a total of 114 for 8. Might not sound much, but it is 16 overs. It's not 20. And the lights are on, and it's the final. Put it all together, they've got a chance.
Charles, who have you got down there?
I got the big fella, the one that bowled really well at the start and put Lancashire on the back foot. Andrew Caddick, well done.
Yeah, but, excuse me, a bit of luck, but a few big shots and thankfully straight down a few couple people's throats. So.
Well, we said all along, didn't we, that the whole key to trying to sort Lancashire out was trying to get through their top order, and you managed to do it. You're the first person that has.
Well, we just had a plan just to be really aggressive for the two main bowlers, opening bowlers, come and be a bit more aggressive, be a bit harder on them. Just shame that second ball, Richard Johnson didn't hold on to that one, because it would have been great. But thankfully, he held on to the fourth one, so fourth ball, so we can't complain.
OK, now, if at the start of the game and the start of that innings, I had offered you 114 for eight for Lancashire, would you have taken it?
Yes, I would. So I think the guys have done a great job there. It's up to the batters now to really knuckle in, use the conditions. It's pretty hard work out there in the field. The ball's getting wet. So hopefully, if our batsmen can really show that they're up for the job, and hopefully they'll come out on top.
11 batters in the side, Andy. It could be down to you.
10 batters in the side, Charles. And hopefully it won't be down to me.
It might be. All right, good luck. Have a good second half.
Cheers,
back upstairs.
Thank you, Charles. Well, I'm glad I didn't interview Andy Caddick then. Charles Colville's about 6'4", and Caddick was towering over him then. 114 for eight then for Lancashire. 16 overs aside this match reduced to. Stuart Law, the outstanding performance. 59 run out off the final delivery, made from just 45 balls. Only two other men in double figures. Andy Simons, who was run out brilliantly by Wes Durston, and Crook down the order, who made 15. 114 for eight from 16 overs.
A good all-round team performance from Somerset. Good figures. The Seamers did the work. Early damage got rid of the superstars of Lancashire, but it's good to see two English qualified bowlers, Andrew Caddick and Richard Johnson. 2 for 21, 3 for 26, with loads of overseas players. Two English qualified boys came to the party in the final. A good all-round team bowling performance.
Certainly was a wonderful team performance from Somerset with the ball. They now need to do it with the bat. They need 115 runs to win from 96 balls at just over 7 runs per over. Plenty of quality outfield cricket from the Somerset Sabres. Wickets galore, Caddick to the fore. We will review all that has happened in this first part of the 2020 final when we come back.
Welcome back to the Brit Oval. The lights are on, the skies are dark now, and we're well into the final of the 2020 Cup for 2005. It's 16 overs aside because of rain earlier on, and Lancashire, well, they've made 114 for eight, which is a very different sort of score from the effort they managed in the semi-final against Surrey, where they racked up over 200. Somerset need 115 to win. They've got just about 720 to get per over. David Lloyd is with me. What do you think?
Well, I said it'd be a different pitch. I think that the lights have kicked in. It's very, very moist atmosphere out there, and this pitch is different now. The ball may swing. Lancashire, I'll tell you, will think they've got a real sniff of this with the attack that they've got.
Well, I tell you, Somerset, I think they've got a real sniff of it as well.
Yeah, it's nothing like the first semi-final when Lancashire scored 217. We've got a different pitch and a different set of circumstances. You've got runs on the board. Is it enough? It's about 7.2, as you say, per over. Somerset, if they play as well as they can do, they should counter it, but you never, never know. Ball starts swinging and nipping around and it's skidding through.
Yeah, they got Anderson, they got Cork. Let's have a look and see exactly how Lancashire managed to get themselves to these scores. I was impressed with the way that Somerset fielded.
Captaincy has been sensational for me from Graeme Smith. He's a brilliant catch and a good field setting there to Mal Loy. Andrew Flintoff tries to take the initiative. Ian Blackwell calls the catch. Safe pair of hands, Blackwell. But the captaincy, we're keeping slips in and keeping the pressure on Lancs, certainly did the trick, but this pitch did a little bit and it moved in the air because of the atmosphere.
And we ought to talk about Stuart Law, because his innings, when you consider what was going on all around him, was outstanding.
Good job he turned up. Stuart Law played a measured innings. And there's that slipping position again. Kept two slips in, even when the fielding positions had gone. He's bowled well, Johnson, full length, picks the ball up. But it's doing a bit, and Lancashire will still feel they've got a real sniff of this game.
A little bit of turn for Blackwell.
He's a canny bowler, isn't he? He's a real good bowler in one-day cricket. Backs himself, full of confidence. Here's Stuart Law again. He just held the innings together.
Stuart Law's knock was outstanding and must put him in line for man of the match. And of course, that's still a long way off because we yet to see who wins this game. Good catch by Carl Gazzard, who's had a very good day today.
Excellent day. Done really well. We talk about all the big stars, and then these young kids come in and they say, hey, look at me, I'm doing my job as well. If Somerset play anything like in this game, they walk it. But it's a final and you never know.
OK, we need to get upstairs to the commentary box, where Ian Ward is with Nasser Hussain.
OK, then, Graeme.
Thank you, Charles. Graeme Smith, the Somerset captain, and will open the innings. 24 years old, but vastly experienced. Right, Seems like he's been around for ages. The Somerset captain, the South African captain, he'll be facing a man who looks a little bit fired up for this occasion. Dominic Cork from the pavilion end. Cork starts with a wide first slip and a gully, and the verbals have started. Dominic is bang up for it. He will be full of effort with body and full of voice. Nasser Hussain and I were discussing whether Marcus Trescothick might be pushed up to open the batting. He batted three in the first semi-final. Well, he's there. Three matches, that best of 56 you saw at the bottom of the caption. It was last year when he opened the batting as well. And Cork is going to try all his tricks. Robert Croft is sat alongside me. What do you reckon? Good move, Trescothick opening?
I'll tell you in 15 overs.
No. I want something now.
Personally, I wouldn't have broken up the plan that they'd already had. I think this middle part of the innings will be crucial. In fairness to Smith and Wood, they've got them to finals date. They've got them into the final. And they've just broken it up. Yeah, I take your point that Trescothick is obviously a quality player. He opens in Test cricket and one day cricket, but he does that with the quality of players he's got around him, and that's the best position to do it for the England team. I think when you pick a side, you pick your 11, but you also have to look at what position they come in best, where they're best suited, and you know, he's a quality player, there's no getting away from that, but we'll wait and see.
And Smith's away, down to third man. Lancashire Lightning boys are fired up, let me tell you. Flintoff has been in Graeme Smith's ear. Andy Simons has been in Graeme Smith's ear. It's obvious Dominic Cork's not been in Graeme Smith's ear. Won't do anything differently. Trescothick to face his first delivery. He's keen, shall we say.
He's chomping at the bit. I can tell you Andy Flintoff's going to be very vocal out there. He'll be the enforcer for the Lancashire team. He's a big unit. He's a guy who's got a fantastic reputation as a cricketer now around the world. He'll be trying to use everything he's got to get on top of the Somerset team. There's Stuart Law there, played a fantastic knock. He held his head when everybody else around him lost theirs, and he's given them a little bit of a sniff.
I'm sure if Stuart Law was chewing on some gum or chuntering away to himself there. Last ball of the first over. And Trescothick's away. He might be away with two. And he decides against it. So a tidy over from Dominic Cork. Two without loss. That's all pretty good natured, isn't it? Seems a lot of people walking about the middle of the pitch.
Yeah, I don't think it's very good natured. I mean, there's smiles going on, but it's simmering. It's looking to boil. Because he'll be putting two arms in there, winding it all up, I can tell you. This is what it's about, though. This is why these guys are playing it and not everybody else. I mean, in fairness, cricket at this level, you have to have the skill, but you also have to have the mental strength to cope with pressure situations. And you can certainly see the way that, for me, the wicket has changed, the atmosphere has changed. We saw in the two semi-finals, especially, when spin played a large part, but certainly in the first innings of this game, seam has done the damage.
Jimmy Anderson from the Vauxhall end. Big shout, Peter Willey not interested, straight away, walks away, and Graeme Smith's nearly run out at the other end. All action cricket here in the second part of this 2020 finals. Just an inquiry from Jimmy Anderson as to why it wasn't given out. Trescothick advancing down the track. probably sliding down, long way down the pitch, wasn't he, Robert?
He's a long way down. There's the run-out chance. Now he's back home. But I think the fact that he was so far down the wicket saved him there.
Both Cork and Anderson have found some swing back into the left-handers. It's been intense stuff so far. We've only had 8 deliveries. The Lightning boys are right on it. Know they've got a below-par total. They know they need wickets with the new ball. They know they have to scrap, they have to fight. Single for Triscothic. This is one of the other reasons why I was quite glad to see, from a Somerset point of view at any rate, Triscothic come out with Graeme Smith. These two, the most adept at playing the new ball, the swinging ball. This is the Lancashire Lightning's best chance of victory if they can knock over wickets with a new ball. And these two are the best equipped in the Somerset lineup to deal with this circumstance and all the pressure. Finals day, big crowd, Flintoff in your ear, Cork in your ear, Simons in your ear. These two are used to it. They've done it time and time again for their respective countries. It's great to see domestic cricket play with such intensity. Brilliant shot. Swivel pull from Graeme Smith, and that has roared away to the fine leg boundary. The first boundary of the Somerset Sabres innings.
Yeah, Jimmy Anderson just too straight. And there's a good pickup off the hip area. Nobody home at fine leg. Got a deep backward square, but not a fine leg. Four runs. There you go. Quick hands. Quickly into position. Head over the ball. Four runs.
Take the boundary, then the single.
Oh, Jimmy!
That was the first real aggressive shot, the boundary from Smith, that we've seen so far. Contrast that to the way the Lightning openers went about it. They were looking for boundaries to look to play their normal way that they've played when the sun was out, the wicket was dry.
Yeah, that's one of the benefits of batting second. At least you have the experience of seeing how the side batting first approaches their innings. And that's almost a carbon copy of the four that Smith hit just now. Superb. Aaron in line. He just picks it up off the hip again. Nobody home at fine leg. And that slides all the way down there for four runs.
Wonderful shot from Triscothic. Always going to be four. And he keeps his eye on the ball, flips it round to fine leg, knows no one's down there. Anderson gets a great big lump out of the footholes. Yeah, it just slipped a little bit. It is damp, the dew is around. Gets not only onto the outfield, but onto the footholes, onto the wicket. The batsman to come, Wood, who has been opening in the 2020. He's down to 3, Blackwell 4, Hildreth 5. Parsons, Wes Dursley, man of the match from the first semi-final. To apologise to Carl Gazzard, it was in fact Wes Dursley. It was not man of the match, it was Gazzard. Smith scrambles another 4.
Yeah, slightly lucky there, that's 3 fours in the last 4 balls. But isn't it amazing how many runs have gone down to fine leg today in finals day? A decent delivery, just nipping back, trying to force it. Just gets that inside edge, it goes down for 4 runs. But fine leg has been a real productive area on finals day for batsmen.
Now extra cover's productive. Cork has managed to swing the ball back into the left-handers. And Smith has counteracted that using his feet down the track. And he's blitzed one through the offside.
He's taken it to the Lancashire team. He's trying to impose himself. He's trying to show his team what it's all about. It's one of those iffy totals that if you start trying just to play to 115, you can get yourself into trouble. But he's going out there. He's showing to the Somerset team what it's all about. He's saying, guys, look, we're here. We're here because we're good enough and we're going to take the cup.
More use of the feet from Smith. This time, no run in shoes. Qualified as the best third place team in the preliminary rounds of this 2020 Cup into the quarter final. Somerset beating Northants to get through to this finals day today. Got away with it. He'll certainly get a couple. He may get three. Long chase for Glenn Chappell. Not quite such a convincing shot.
Not really. But when you've got this fielding restrictions in, you can chance your arm. That's gone high over extra cover. Three runs. He's certainly getting off to a flyer. And the pressure on the Lancashire team now must be immense. They know they need wickets. They know they've got to keep that ball in the business area. But on a deck like this, which for the majority of the time has been a superb batting wicket, that can yield quick runs.
Graeme Smith has scored a few runs in this over. A couple of boundaries and a two. Good comeback here from Dominic Court. The ball is getting wet. Court went over to umpire Gould and grabbed a rag from the umpire just to dry it, so it's greasy. That'll make the ball just a little bit soft. It will negate any of the swing. Tough for batsmen and bowlers, these conditions. Bit of thigh involved then. Just a leg by that finishes the over. 23 without loss. Somerset 23 without loss. Three overs gone. This final reduced to 16 overs per side. They need another 92 runs to win from 78 balls. All 10 wickets remain. Change of bowling at the Vauxhall end. Jimmy Anderson has been whipped out of the attack after one over. Andrew Flintoff has the ball in his hand.
Yeah, interesting move here from the Lancashire captain, Chilton. He's brought his enforcer on. If you look at the way that Cork and Anderson bowl, they predominantly look to bring the ball back into the left-handed batsman, whereas you look at Flintoff, the style of bowling he's got, he will look to move the ball away from the left-handed batsman with those two slips. And for me, he's probably one of the best bowlers to left-handed batsmen in the country.
An example there. Rueful grin from Graeme Smith. This was a beauty. Pace and bounce, and Smith got himself into all sorts of trouble.
This is what he wants. Speed there, 87.4 miles an hour from the big man Flintoff. He's certainly up for it. These two have locked horns on a number of occasions in international cricket. Now they're doing it on 2020 finals day.
If my lip reading's correct, something along the lines of, don't chop those on, Smithy. Bit of byplay. The big man wants it. He wants his hand on the trophy. Smith improvising, backs away, looks to give himself room for the shot through the offside. Don't chop on there, Smithy, he says. Don't drag it back onto your stumps. You reckon about that tactic, backing away?
Well, I think at this stage, with the start they've had, he'd be far better off staying in line with his stumps. Because in fairness, he is a very, very good player through the leg side. And by backing away to the leg side, he's only opening up the offside to himself. So he's playing slightly alien to himself. But he's the man in the middle. He's the captain of Somerset. He's also the captain of South Africa. So I suppose he's backing what he does.
Handy for Somerset. Just got that really didn't know a lot about that. Another good delivery from Andrew Flintoff, 88 miles an hour. Smiles from the Somerset pair, but they know they're in their battle here. No chance for Warren Hegg.
Oh, so much has gone Somerset's way so far today. When they've been bowling, any time the opposition's chopped the ball, they've chopped it onto the stumps. And when Somerset have been batting, when they've dragged it, it's just missed the stumps. It seems to be going their way.
Joseph Scothick's gone. Flintoff has his man. He's fired up. Lancashire are fired up. They're all converging on the big man. The Lancashire supporters are even spilling their beer. They're that excited. And Marcus Scothick has gone for 10. A big, big wicket.
He's pumped. Flintoff is pumped. He's running in middle late 80s every ball. A short wide delivery, got an under edge. And a simple catch there for Hegg. But there you go, look at him, he's trying to get his team up for it. He's certainly up for it. And he sees an opportunity to get back into this game.
Scothick's gone for 10, Somerset 28 for 1. We've seen Andrew Flintoff fired up in the international matches. Great to see him fired up in equal measure for his Lancashire teammates. Matthew Wood, who has previously been opening for the Sabres, in the absence of Marcus Scothick, comes to the crease at number 3. 24 years old. Decent strike rate. He played sensibly in the first semi-final against Leicestershire. Just looked to knock the ball around. Didn't try and play anything too flash until he was well set. He's got a job to do here with his captain, Graeme Smith. The ball is nipping around a little bit. And Glenn Chattel is on from the pavilion end. 10 matches in his 2020 Cup this year. 7 wickets. Fairly expensive. But you fancy he will hit the seam in good areas, Chattel.
Yes. And, this is a big wicket if they can take Smith now. And certainly they're going to be flying into the young man Wood, both the way they bowl, and take it from me verbally, they'll be letting him know that he's in a battle. They'll be trying to work him over mentally just to see if he's, how his ticker is. Can he handle the pace? Can he handle the pressure? You can see in his eyes, look at that. He's trying to concentrate as hard as he can. This is certainly the biggest day in this young man's career.
Two slips for Glenn Chattel. Just an adjustment in the field. Fine leg, deep square leg on the boundary, and a third man. Rest saving one. And a bit of a flash outside the off stump.
Here we go, this is the Flintoff wicket. An under edge there to Warren Hegg. And look at Freddie. You can see as well the way that the Lancashire team are pumped. Every ball that just dribbles down, they're all flying in. And let me tell you, they're not all just going for the ball. They're all letting Wood know that he's in a battle.
Up and over and down to the third man boundary for 4. 33-1. And Matt Wood is off the mark. Charles, you down there in the dugout?
Well, down here in the dugout, the fall of Marcus Scothick's wicket just gave a little bit of tension in the air, but that fall's relieved it a little bit. I've got Keith Parsons with me. He's trying to look as cool and as calm as usual. Seen it all before, though, Keith.
Yeah, we have, yeah. It's different in the final, but yeah, we're going along all right. Obviously now, disappointing Marcus got out.
You weren't so long ago a man of the match in a C&G final. How does this day compare?
Well, it's very different because obviously C&G's only one game. This is 2 days. It's much more, you know, much more intense and spread out over a long time. So, yeah, it was a good occasion that day, and it'd be nice to come away with another win.
And you must have been absolutely delighted with the way that you kept Lancashire's much-vaunted run machine down to within manageable proportions.
Yeah, I'm sure we'd have taken that at the start. I mean, they're a hugely dangerous side to bowl up against, and we got early wickets, which was the key. That was what we set out to try and do, and we achieved that, so...
And what's it like at the moment to be so close to getting your hands on that 2020 Cup? I mean, if you have another good 45 minutes of cricket here, it's yours.
Well, I'm sure 16 other counties would like to be in this opportunity, so it's great. And we, you know, as you say, if we play well for the next 11 overs, we've got a great chance of winning the 2020, so that'll be fantastic.
Who's to say that you might not hit the winning runs?
Might not even get in, Charles.
Might not. You might. What number are you going in?
6.
Well, I think you might get in. Yeah. Who knows? Right, let's get back upstairs.
Charles reckons he'll get in. He reckons Lancashire have got a few more wickets in them yet. Not sure that would have done Keith Barnes' confidence much good, actually, having a conversation with Charles there. Never mind. Flintoff has the ball in his hand. Just the one slip this time for Graeme Smith. 82 to win from 66 deliveries. Here comes the big man. Another swivel pull for Graeme Smith. It's just a single, brings Matthew Wood on strike, and Flintoff will target this bloke, won't he?
Oh, he's going to have some chin music here. Hope he knows how to hook or pull, because in fairness, Flintoff's natural length is just back of a length. And with the way this pitch seems to have speeded up, the extra zip that's coming off it, see if he moves in another catcher. Must be tempted to do that. Must be tempted. The only way back into this game now is to pick up two or three quicker wickets. Simons is coming over to have a word as well, as well as Chilton. They're the brains trust. Good grief.
So after the brains trust have met, there's a change in the field. And goes out in the point boundary. A scampered single. That was a quick delivery, a heavy delivery from Andrew Flintoff. Right on the money. Heavy atmosphere out there. Yeah, moist. We've had some rain. We've got some cloud cover up above the lights. Just all adds to the atmosphere. This wonderful new stand here at the Oval. The gas holders in the background. Full crowd. Lots of pressure. Wonderful theatre. Again, a good pull shot from Smith. Might come back for two this time, and does so. Good cricket.
Yeah, terrific run in there from the Somerset captain. Keady, in fairness, got round there and stopped it. Well, got his body in line, but seemed to take an age to get back up and get the ball in the air. That's what we all say. He's got around there, and you can see he's turned with intent. He's pumping those legs, he's getting back up there. I think he saw the fact that Keady took a while to get up and get the ball in the air.
Wide. Wide and well taken by Warren Hegg. He had to make a lot of ground to his left in his final year of cricket for Lancashire. He would love to go out with a trophy under his belt. Been a wonderful servant for Lancashire cricket and indeed English cricket. And that's what they're all playing for. That's what it's all about. Get your hands on that.
They're just starting to eke the run rate up. It's the first way they can check it. The original rate was 7.19 per over. Now it's moving its way up to 7.45. I think they've got to do it with wickets. But if you can't do that, the next best thing is to move the run rate up.
The Lancashire captain, Chilton, is getting advice from all quarters. Glenn Chappell is having a quiet word on his captain's ear. Again, Smith goes to the leg side and bounces it into the surface and over the head of the captain. Two runs in shoot. Comparison is Lancashire were 43 for 5 at this stage, Somerset 40 for 1, so 4 wickets to the good. That could be the crucial figure, Robert.
Definitely. The best way to slow a side down is to take wickets. You also don't give them the option to launch again later on. They had to regroup in that middle stage. Dewey Law did that pretty well, but ended up 20 runs shy, 30 runs shy of where they'd like to be.
End of the sixth over, 42 for 1, Somerset. Just the one wicket full, that of Marcus Triscothic. Andrew Flintoff got his England colleague, caught behind by Warren Hegg for 10. Smith on 25, Wood on 5. Blackwell, Hildreth, Parsons, Durson, Gazzard, Johnson, Langerfeld and Andrew Caddick, the men to come. Four bowlers used, two overs for Dominic Cook, 0 for 12. Just the one for Jimmy Anderson. Flintoff, two overs, one for 14, the priceless one the priceless one wicket of Marcus Trescothick.
Do you fancy he'll gamble and give the four overs straight off to Andy Flintoff now?
Certainly an option. He's fired up enough for it. Seattle just straying down the leg side. I think I probably would. I think I would probably keep them under pressure. If they can break this partnership, particularly if they can get rid of Smith, that would be a huge blow to Somerset. So I would perhaps gamble with Andrew Flintoff bowling straight away. What do you reckon?
Yeah, often I think when you're captain, you have to think what the opposition would least like to face. And I'm sure Smith and Wood would least like to face Andrew Flintoff now.
Wood's crashed that away. Andy Simons at backward point raises his arm to the man at third man to say it's yours, mate. Well, he had no chance. Used the pace of the ball, placed it perfectly. Good boundary.
He gives himself some room. He was also given the length to move into that shot. Past backward points, left hand and to the right of third man. An area that right-handers love to hit the ball in, especially with people who are giving you some pace. You can't defend that, really.
Lovely timing from Wood. What a wonderful shot. Stuart Law will get up and try and chase it. He managed to get a hand on it, but he does time the ball so well, Matthew Wood. That's a wonderful way to bring up your team's 50.
They're moving on nicely now. A couple of boundaries are coming, which is easing the pressure, not only on Wood, but for the team of Somerset. Full half volley, and he moves into it nicely. A despair. Look at that effort. It was superb, but couldn't quite get to it. He knows as soon as he's hit it, it's come out the middle of the bat.
And again, another crisp shot from Wood, and he's found the boundary again. 3-3. Wonderful bit of timing from Matthew Wood. Two boundaries on the offside, and now a beautiful clip through straight mid-wicket.
Yes, certainly, it's come over to my side. He's had a backward cut, he's had an extra cover drive, and now he's clipped it through the mid-wicket area, playing all around the wicket, showing what a good player he is. I think it's getting to that stage where the captain now is going to have to bring on his spin option.
Up and over again, and that's another boundary. Crook won't stop that. 4-4 for Matthew Wood. What a gem of an over this for Somerset and for Matt Wood. Three crunching boundaries, and Chappell just hasn't found his line and length.
Doesn't Smith love it the other end? He's watching some fantastic stroke play. Again, banged it in just back of a length outside off stump. He's cut it over point's head. Even Andy Simons couldn't stop that. This is a superb over so far for Somerset. Already 16 off it.
Come back from Chappell, full and straight and underneath the bat of Matthew Wood. 56 from 55 balls. It's a runner ball, that's all it is, with 9 wickets in hand. Keady to bowl. Andy Simons has to bowl. What will he bowl? Will he bowl off spin or seam on this, do you think, Robert?
I think he's going to have to try spin now, because I think their first three-seam bowlers, four-seam bowlers have gone around the park. They need to change the pace.
That ends the seventh over, 60 for one. Matthew Wood on fire in this over from Glenn Chappell. 4 boundaries, the first through backward point. Wonderful off drive that beats the despairing dive of Stuart Law. Then a clip through straight mid-wicket. Perfect balance and poise. And then he carves it high and up and over Andrew Simons at backward point. Crisis over. Really was a bonus for the Somerset Savers. The required rate has dropped now to 6.1. That's what it's all about. That's what they want to get their hands on.
Yeah, sensible cricket gets them home now. Got to keep the intensity of the Somerset team. They realise that Lancashire have got to keep their catches in, so that should give them some more room. And he's gone! What a superb delivery! Look how pumped he is! Real heat! Bowling 88, 89 miles an hour. He's coming in. Wood just not quite up to the task this time. Inside edge and drops onto middle stump.
Well, he played so well the over before when he was taking 4 boundaries off Glenn Chappell, but it's the extra aggression and pace of Flintoff. A little bit of movement back into the right-hander. Wood perhaps not quite in behind it. And it's a thick inside edge onto the stumps. Big wicket for Lancashire. It had to happen then. Matthew Wood's gone for 22, Somerset 60 for 2. Still needing 55 to win from 53 balls. Full applause and support from his teammates in the dugout for Matthew Wood. This man holds the key for me, Robert. He's fired up. He's got the two wickets. He's given his side a chance. Bowl him out, bowl him through, let him have his head.
Yeah, he's got 11 balls left to change the game for Lancashire. He's certainly the man of the moment. As we see Ian Blackwell coming in, 27. Hero Viv Richards, a fantastic player he was. Happy Gilmore's film, and he loves a golf. Bet he smacks it a long way, just like he does a cricket ball.
Up and over. Will he get there, Stuart Law? No, he can't. Will it run to the boundary? No, it's pulled back. Blackwell off the mark with a very streaky two, and that to me looked like he was done for a bit of pace there.
He's got his tail up now as Andrew Flintoff. He realises his team needs him, Lancashire need him. He's coming in, he's hitting the pitch real hard. Blackwell was done for pace, just gets enough bat in it to spew off over the slip region. Stuart Law keeps it in so it doesn't go for a boundary, but this is full-on intense cricket now. 2020 cricket at its best.
Blackwell again has a go at the pull shot, bit of a mix-up between the two left-handers at the crease, but they scamper through, and Blackwell, I imagine, will be quite relieved to be down the non-striker's end. Andrew Flintoff has bowled 2.5 overs, so he's got a maximum of 9 deliveries left to influence this 2020 final. A little bit of extra bounce and pace we're seeing, and we know Flintoff's quick, but perhaps a bit of dew on the wicket as well.
Yeah, it's on the wicket now, it's got to be falling on it. Certainly think if I was a batsman, I'd forget about coming forward with the seeing the mood that Flintoff is in. Just hang back around your stumps, look to work him away for ones, you look to use up his 4 overs without losing any more wickets.
Yes, we're in top gear, mate.
Mikey Loy might have done himself an injury. It's as if he's hobbling around a little bit. Sure, he will try and run this off. He won't want to go off.
It's all that sweeping he does, going down on one leg.
Cracking shot from Smith, but he's going to get no runs for it. Right in the slot for the big drive. And Chappell, sprawling to his left, does very well.
Terrific effort. I think he's looking to hang back now, Smith. And if it's up there, he'll give a full swing of the bat. It's kept mid-off up, which is a good move, not to give them easy singles. Cuts it off.
Shot from Smith. Will he get 4? He has to defend the boundary. It's Dominic Court. He'll scamper back for 2. That's the end of the 8th over. 65 for 2. Somerset 65-4-2. Need another 50 more runs to win from 8 overs. There's a change in bowling. Gary Keeney will come on from the pavilion end. Change 2 in the commentary box. Nasser Hussain is with David Lloyd.
Thanks, Ian. We've got a spin. Gary Keeney into the attack. Somerset 50 from 48. It's a doddle. Put it into a one-day international talk sport game. It's an absolute doddle. But this is a final. Done it again, Gary Keeney. Gets big wicket, Stuart Law. Safe hands down there at long on. Ian Blackwell fancied Keeney. You're going to go. It's Blackwell who's going.
Good work, Mark Chilton. Wasn't scared of bringing his left arm spinner on. That's the short boundary towards the old pavilion. Stuart Law takes the catch. Blackwell goes, miss hit. Keeney a wicket in his first delivery. Blackwell goes for 3, Somerset 65 for 3, game on.
Well, we said 50 from 48, it's a doddle. Just knock it around, win the game. Finals just play on the mind. Somerset in this big game. James Hildreth is the new batsman. His hero is Mike Davis. Mike's Fantasia and the sport tiddlywinks. Well, he does look a bit of a winker to me. I'm sure he's a star at it. Keady with a bit of left arm spin. Will it spin? I should think it'll just skid on.
Very similar.
Lancashire need Graeme Smith. They need two new batsmen. If they get that man on your screen, we're going to have a cracking final. Smith stays there at the end. Somerset win. It's as simple as that, I believe. They get a wicket here. The pressure on this Somerset side will be immense. That captain, Chilton, he knows it. Can they get Smith?
Just sit in the game. They can do, just for a little while. Just over halfway through the innings. See if Somerset hold the nerve. Do they get a little bit twitchy? Graeme Smith, yes, holds the key.
Steady!
Two runs to Smith, the sweep shot. They did collapse in the semi-final, Bumble, about this stage. Bowling of Snape, Mongia, Henderson, 5 for 22. Spinners did most of the damage. Introduction of spin in the final has immediately got a wicket. Maybe Andrew Simons, a little bit of spin at the end. Flintoff's fired up, though.
Flintoff's ball 3 overs, 2 for 19. Simons is the other spin option. Big sweeps again. Might just get to the boundary here. Graeme Smith. Well, he's not calming things down for Somerset. They will feel that they're winning this game quite easily. Hey, up. The knees up.
I have no idea what that dance was. It's worked for Graeme Smith. 4 runs.
I tell you, they're having a knees up down there. Here we go. Nine overs have gone, 71 for 3. Graeme Smith, 33 from 30 deliveries. James Hildreth, well, he hasn't had strike yet. Still to get off the mark. Mark Chilton, who's he going to turn to? Will it be spin? Yes, it will. Andrew Simons into the attack.
One of these equations, 44 of 42. 7 wickets in hand. Crowd have had a cracking day, they really have. The weather might have been miserable at times, but they've had some of the best cricketers in the world on this stage. And there's one of them, Andrew Simons. Looks like he's bowling off spin. And if someone could make things happen,
it
could well be the man. He's had a really good season with Australia and Lancashire. Can he make something happen here?
And James Hildreth is a player. He's only a young boy. 20 years of age. Seen him play some really good innings for Somerset. Strong hitter, but he hits the ball in good areas. He's not a slogger. Thrown the ball to Simons, turned this game. You can sense that Lancashire, they need 2 quick wickets. You can feel it, that they're looking, probing for wickets. Got both spinners on. Wicket for Keady's from his first ball, got rid of Ian Blackwell. Andrew Simons' ball around the wicket to Graeme Smith. Full toss, just be a single.
End of a one-day international, you'd say 42 off 39. Got a real chance. Close game. Difference here is that only 3 wickets have gone down. We've still got batsmen in. Hildreth, as David Lloyd says, a quality player. Good fielding there. Chappell, the fielder. We still have batsmen in. Graeme Smith and Hildreth. So they should see him home. couple of wickets, get the all-rounders in, get the bowlers in, then you never know.
There'll be a push here for two. Andrew Crook, the fielder down there, it's greasy. Was two anyway. And Lancashire looking just to turn the screw, just to get two overs together, quiet overs. Push this required rate up, it's 6.49, it's a double. Another single to Crook down the ground, 76 for three. Simon's one over, good over for Lancashire. He's went for five. Gary Keady starts his second over. He's got one for six. 76 for three. Somerset require 39 from 36. And really, that's all they need to do. Just push and go. Very defensive field from Lancashire. Just four inside the circle. Are Somerset used to winning finals, trophies, big changes at the club? We've also had the glory days, the good old days, if you like. But now they've got a new set of young lads and a new captain, Graeme Smith, who leaves shortly after this game. Go back to South Africa. Ian Blackwell takes over as captain of the side. He'll want to leave him with something, Smith.
Haven't won many trophies. 2001, C&G, win a lot before then, has won a lot since. There is the trophy. Somerset have one hand on that cup. Good over from Keady so far, though. One run off three deliveries. Kate. It's the hardest bit after months of 2020 cricket to do the final bit. Ian Blackwell, he can't do a lot about it anymore. Final bit, just to finish it off. It might seem so easy, 37 off 32. But believe me, it's not. Young and old, Hildreth and Smith got to see it through.
Well, Lancashire will want two of the inexperienced youngsters to come into the crease and try and win this game for Somerset and turn the screw, build the pressure. And again, at this stage, you just sit in the game. Chilton will be working overtime. Has he got the right bowlers on? He probably has. And they're doing okay. Squeeze the game if you can. Stop the run for, stop the boundaries. And then will Somerset do something different? Another useful over from Gary Keady. 11 overs have been bowled. It's 80 for three. Somerset require 35 from 30. Now, will Lancashire keep going? I'm sure that they will. Just have a look at the faces on Somerset's players. Not the one on the left. Andy Caddick there, old campaigner. Where's Durston? Next batsman in. Been thirsty work, I think, today.
Come on in. Roy, let's have one, mate. Boys, right to the death here. Still a little twist, maybe, boys, come on.
Required rate is seven. Andrew Simons to start his second over. Look at Keady's figures, it's working again. One for 10 off two overs. Andy Simons with this first over that he bowled, none for five. Now then, Graeme Smith, stay in, you've got the trophy. Lancashire will field Smith out, they've still got a sniff of this game.
Now then, Andrew Simons, you're an Australian, you're a winner. You have turned games round, bat, ball in the field, do something special. Get a run out, caught and bowled, get a wicket.
Yes.
Don't let them just milk you around for ones. Bring someone up, make them do something different. If you go for ones, you lose the game. Somewhere along the line, there'll be a boundary, an inside edge. Do something different. Get a wicket. Don't wait for it, get one.
Hildreth doing well, just pushing the ball into the gaps. Single, over to the captain, over to the experienced man. I think they're so near Somerset. 33 from 28. Quicker delivery.
Come on, Fred!
Looking for two. Little bit of indecision. Graeme Smith didn't want anything to do with that second run. Misfield from Flintoff. Perhaps right not to take that arm on.
That's why, reputation. Andrew Flintoff, one of the biggest arms in the game. All right, he misfielded, but he wasn't going to risk. He'd take a few people on, but no, that's Andy Flintoff out there. Stay there.
3 singles so far from the over. Simons again.
Yes, chap! Hey, chappie!
The single. Can you detect something a little bit different from Somerset? Do you detect that they're nearly there? Required rate is inching. It's just going a little bit higher, up 7.15. Keith Parsons with his pads on. Do they look like winners? Are they a winning team? Beautiful shot from Graeme Smith. He's worked that into the gap. Welcome boundary.
There you have it. If you go for 4 singles in the over, eventually a class player will find a gap and get the boundary. And before you know it, a good over becomes a bad one. You have to stop the singles. Graeme Smith is too good a player just to let things drift. In his last game, Graeme Smith. What a feeling. Could he lead him to success?
Nimble on his feet as well. Got himself away to the leg side. Last ball of the 12th over. Smith's looking for the strike. Just about gets in. 89 for 3. Somerset, 26 from 24. Holding things together, Graeme Smith, 43 from 39. Truscothic went for 10. Matthew Wood, useful innings, 22 from 13. Ian Blackwell, brief innings, 3 from 3. Wicket for Keady with his first delivery, 2 for Flintoff. Who will it be? They've had lots of debates out there, Lancashire, as to who should bowl. Flintoff's been involved. Stuart Law's been involved. Andrew Simons is involved now. Gary Keady will continue. 4 overs are left.
Flintoff's got to bowl one of them. Keady, possibly 2. Keady's had a good tournament and he's bowled well so far. 2 overs for 10 before that delivery. So Andrew Flintoff, at this stage you need your wicket taker, Mark Chilton. You need someone to do something special. How many times has that man done something special for Lancashire and England? You need a wicket. Get him on now, quickly. 2 wickets in an over. Just the presence of Andrew Flintoff might do something.
Single out to Flintoff there. Important game for Andrew Flintoff, this. He said right at the beginning he's come down to have some fun. He wants to get into the final. He wants to help his team. Doesn't play for Lancashire too often. I just wonder whether Lancashire fans feel and see this game drifting away from them. Somerset were outsiders. He got into these semi-finals and the final day, skin of the teeth. One of the best thirds. Smith just keeps coming down the ground and getting the bottom of the bat. He's making these Keady deliveries into Yorkers. 23 from 21 Somerset need. Required rate, nothing, 6.57. Carl Gazzard, man of the match in that semi-final. Wicketkeeper, young batsman, James Hildreth, 20 years of age. Oh, he's taking Keady on, inside edge, single.
Well, he's doing the right thing, Hildreth. He doesn't want to put Smith under pressure. Doesn't want any dot balls. They don't really want this to go to the last over. Finals day, the final game. You don't want it going to the last two or three balls. We saw that in the NatWest final at Lords. Anything can happen if it goes to the last over. Smith will want this done and dusted before then. Don't want the fiasco of a tie. Want it done by the 15th over. So Hildreth will have to carry on playing some shots.
Big shot, Smith, that's six. He's moved on to 50. He's the captain of the team and he's leading them home.
And his whole team are up in the dugout. The crowd are up. He's leading from the front. A full toss. He made it into a full toss. And with brute strength, he hit it into the old pavilion. That could be the difference, that shot there. 16 off 19 balls now.
First six of the final there. Keeley again. Shite the stitch. No way. Direct hit. We know about direct hits. Ian Gould. Oh, he's given it out, Gould. He's gone to the third umpire. It's safe.
Well, we saw what Ian Gould thought. He has gone to the third umpire. That was just a reference for Mark Chilton. Mark Chilton would have said, what do you reckon, Gunner? Oh, I'm not so sure.
Well, what do you think? Ball's coming in. He's in there. He's in there. Usually, well, we talk all the time about direct hits. Third umpire will make his decision, John Holder. Somerset spectators, supporters will be holding their breath. Graeme Smith, star man. And they'll be put out of the misery any second now. Big screen, umpire's decision. Breathe again. Hundreds on the board, 100 for three. Somerset, 15. From 18 deliveries, they're there, they're home and dry.
Well, Mark Chilton's made the right move. 15 off 18, he's gone for one over of Andrew Flintoff, the big man from Lancashire, from Preston. Can he do anything? Big test match next week. Big over to bowl here. Three overs, two for 19. Come on, Andrew, do something.
From 17. Smith has bossed this innings for Somerset. Captain leading from the front, open the batting. 53 from 44. Five more deliveries. Look at him talking him through, James Hildreth. Just see him off. Just keep picking up these singles. See Flintoff off. Field changes again. Will they have a slip? Will they have a catcher? Chilton directing operations there. Batsmen decide to get together. I feel sure it'll be a slip that comes in. Need wickets. Need to get two wickets. Cause some panic.
Yeah, it's the first signs of plan B. Slip goes in. Chilton realises we need wickets.
Another single.
A little bit lack of communication there. Flintoff and the captain. You put a slip in. Andrew Flintoff bowls a Yorker. Not really going to go to slip. If he was going to carry on bowling Yorkers, keep your man out. If your captain puts a slip in, go back of a length, try and find the edge.
But they could keep a slip in also for Graeme Smith. It's wickets that Lancs need. Somerset need 13 from 16. False start from Flintoff. He's got four deliveries left in his spell. He's given it everything. Ball with real pace. Whacked into the leg side. Will it go for four? Brilliant piece of fielding. Outstanding. Got three. Very Keedy.
A hint of surprise in David Lloyd's voice, because it was Gary Keedy. What has 2020 done to English cricket? That's what it's done. Your left-arm spinner, couldn't really field a few years ago, now he's throwing himself around. Competition that's brought the best out of everyone, batsmen, bowlers, fielders. really has been another fine year of 2020 cricket.
Yes, yes!
Scoring off every delivery now. Don't need to do anything silly. Less than double figures. 9 required from 14 deliveries. Lancashire 114 for 8. Andrew Caddick bowled superbly. He led the Somerset very, very well. Richard Johnson also. Seamers were a handful. Somerset in reply. 106 for 3. Captain is getting them there. Lancashire supporters, spectators will be disappointed. And so Lancashire as a red-hot favourite. But it's Somerset, the outsiders. And they've done terrifically well. They're coming back for 2. Get there comfortably. They need 7. They're 7 away from holding this trophy.
The outsiders, Somerset came from nowhere. Best third place finish got them through. Couple of games on Sky down at Taunton, that man started to get them fired up, Graeme Smith. Blackwell had a few innings. All of a sudden they started to believe they had a plan. Young players like Hildreth played some fine innings. Chilton, captain of the favourites, Lancashire. They look like they're struggling. Well, Graeme Smith, he wants to finish it in a hurry. David Lloyd, it's getting towards your car starting time.
Well, the engine's running, it's hot. Look at these guys here. They deserve the victory. They played some real strong cricket of Somerset. That tight little Taunton ground. They've been superb in the zonal matches. Look at Graeme Smith. He's just pumping Andrew Flint off into the night sky, into the stand. Yes, indeed. Now start the car. Here we go.
And they're up as well. They know they're there. He knows that yet again Lancashire fall at finals day. Graeme Smith pumped up all day. I'm not sure whether he'll sleep well tonight or he won't. He'll be so pumped up. He might need a couple of sherbets just to get him to sleep. Look at the crowd. Look at. It's amazing how people just turn up from nowhere when you're winning. Good effort, Somerset. You deserve it.
There they go, Somerset, all of them, the whole of Somerset. Graeme Smith, two big mates there, Smith and Flintoff. Adversaries at test match level, adversaries here, but it's Somerset. Look at these great scenes, rank outsiders, spoiling the big boys' party, but they've played in style, with style, loads of aggression, and they've had key players in key areas. Somerset have upset the odds. They've beaten Lancashire in this final. They fancied doing it. Look at these young kids here. Gazzard, there he was, man of the match in that first semi-final. Graeme Smith will leave, go back to South Africa, and he's left them with something.
He's left them with a combination of young and old. Caddick, Kruskothic, Smith himself, Johnson, the old, combined with the youngsters. Hildreth there at the end. Wood, Durston, Gazzard. A mixture of young and old. They're both enjoying it. Andrew Caddick's won a lot for England, but he'll savour this moment. Graeme Smith, great effort. He's led from the front. There he is, Andrew Caddick. Well bowled, well batted, skip. The final partnership was 53 in 36 deliveries, and it started those celebrations.
Well, they're great scenes, aren't they? Absolutely marvellous. Charles, where are you down there?
Well, I'm right down here in the middle of it all. I've just grabbed James Hildreth, who's just hit the winning runs. How did that feel?
Yeah, I'm buzzing at the moment. Unbelievable. Especially the side we've got, young, exuberant. The side we're playing against, obviously some star players there. We've gone out with a no-fear attitude, and it's paid off for us today.
Well, it's been a brilliant day for you. There was that really tight semi-final against Leicestershire. There must have been times when you doubted you'd do it.
There wasn't one time when I doubted that we'd do it. We always thought we could do it, otherwise we wouldn't have won it. Because there were times in the game where it could have been perceived that they were ahead, but as you know, cricket's a funny game and we've fought through it. battled hard and won the game.
And then what was it like just out here with Graeme Smith, who seemed to have a very much of a game plan, how he wanted to win it, and just kept talking to you?
Yeah, he told me what to do, basically. I mean, this batting innings was because of him. I mean, he's batted awesome there. And yeah, like I said, he just told me everything to do.
You better get off and join the celebrations, mate. Well done. Yeah, I think you might. OK, back upstairs.
Well, it used to be Somerset with Ian Botham and Viv Richards and Joel Garner. Check these names out. Matt Wood, James Hildreth, Wes Durston, Carl Gazzard. And they've won this 2020 final. Terrific scenes for these boys. Yeah, the nerves have been jangling all day. There's young and there's old. Richard Johnson has played his part. Ball real full and well. First ever 2020 game today. Lancashire can reflect and watch these Somerset celebrations. Charles Langerfeld there has played his part. Charles, where are you now?
Well, I'm still in the middle of it all. I'm with Marcus Truscothick. Marcus, you've won all sorts of things in your career all over the place. I won't keep you for long because the lap of honour is about to take place, but where does this rate?
Yeah, it's pretty good. Special day. Obviously, it's my first 2020 game for the team this summer. I'm delighted for the boys, man. They've been absolutely brilliant today. They've shown so much character, which has surprised me a little bit because we struggled early season. And to do what they've done and really come back and win this competition is brilliant.
Actually, it must be quite difficult in a way for you to come into this side because you've been out of it and missing for so much with the summer, then suddenly just a swan in for the final.
Yeah, unfortunately, someone had to miss out. But, you know, it's just the way it was. But, you know, there's never any problem in terms of, you know, the character-wise. You know, they always welcome me back very easily. It's just a case of fitting back into the routine and under their plans.
And just nice to be back with the boys and maybe away from that pressure of England.
Yeah, we never get away from it because obviously you've got a bit of time off, but you're always preparing for next week. Still a lot of pressure on today's cricket. You're expected to do well, and when you're back for your club, you're always under pressure with them.
OK, you better go and join the lap of honour. Thanks a lot. Cheers.
Well, you can tell that there's genuine affection for Graeme Smith there. He's come in as captain. He looks absolutely shattered from his efforts of the day. You bring a guy in, an overseas player, and you hope that he fits into your team. You make him captain. And he's certainly left them with something. We see Graeme Smith at international level. Do you see the aggression, the commitment of Graeme Smith? And he seems to have brought that to Somerset. Yeah, go on, boys, you milk it. You've had a great day. Well, what do they call them? The tractor boys. They've had a marvellous day here. The cider boys. Look at him. He's absolutely shattered. He's given it everything. Ian Blackwell, big lad, takes over as captain. Very, very shortly, he's already done one job, one game. Richard Johnson came into this team. He has lots of injuries, troublesome injuries. Marcus Truscothick, wow, he says. Having a stroll round. Milking this lap of honour. That's Richard Johnson's done well.
Yeah, they took the gamble, Somerset. They left out a few of their younger lads and went to experience in Johnson and Langerveld. And in the end, it proved the right way to go. Experience told on the biggest stage. They mixed it up well. The youngsters and the old men, the Lancashire boys, they look distraught. The coach cannot believe it. Warren Hegg cannot believe it. Semi-finals last year against Surrey, finals this year against Somerset. They are the favourites. They were the favourites, Lancashire. Their batting lineup, they had everyone. Everyone you'd wish to have in a 2020 shirt was in that Lancashire batting lineup. And all of a sudden, they were 41 for 5 and they were blown away. And they really did not know how to react. Five of the best players you'd want to see all back in the pavilion because of Graeme Smith, his tactics, all his plans were absolutely perfect. And then he went out there himself and led them to victory. You cannot ask for anything else from your captain and from your teammates behind you.
Well, they've loved him. You can see it. Graeme Smith has left them with something. Lancashire are left to reflect. Red hot favourites, not nearly enough, 114 for 8, but that really was the excellence of Somerset's bowling. It did a little bit of something in the night time and the lights and a little bit of moisture around. You take nothing away from this team. Thoroughly deserved the win. And they chased down that modest 114 for 8. Stuart Law scoring 59. Somerset knocked them off. Graeme Smith very much to the fore 118 for three. Seems an easy win. Big, big smiles from Somerset. Well played. Been another memorable day. Here we are, just look at these names. Graeme Smith, we all know about Graeme Smith. World-class performer, captain of South Africa, 64 from 47. He's done his job as opening batsman and as captain. Triscothy for 10. Matthew Wood, 22 from 13. And young James Hildreth, 16 from 14, 118 for 3.
Well, all the bowlers tried really hard. They were only protecting 114. Flintoff was the pick of the bowlers yet again. Two wickets for 33. Keady, as he's done throughout this tournament, came on, got a wicket straight away. Simons tried, Chappell tried, Anderson didn't bowl a lot. But to be honest, they didn't get enough runs. Their bowlers tried hard. They fielded as well as they could. But once, their batting lineup failed.
Well, the 2020 Cup Final 2005 has gone to Somerset. They've won by 7 wickets. And it's been a fabulous day. Little bit of rain, but who cares? We got a winner in the end, and Somerset have thoroughly deserved it. Back with the presentation very shortly.
Welcome back to the Brit Oval, where the 2020 Cup has been decided for 2005, and it's gone to Somerset, the unfancied side. They have beaten Lancashire, the red-hot favourites, and they've beaten them comfortably in the end. It was a slightly reduced game because of rain, but in the end, that didn't matter. Somerset were worthy winners. And let's find out about who's man of the match and all that sort of stuff, and see Somerset get that cup. It's presentation time with Ian Ward.
It is indeed. Thank you very much, Charles. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the presentation. We've seen three cracking games of cricket, two wonderful semi-finals and a tense final here at the Brit Oval. Wonderful cricket all round from all the players involved here today, and also a great effort from the Oval ground staff to get play underway. Now it's time for the victorious Somerset side to come forward and collect their winner's medal. So if the team could come forward in approximate batting order. Don't be shy, Marcus, if you want to lead them off. Graeme, if you could come last, please. Graeme Smith, the captain. So Marcus Triscothick picking up his winner's medal. Just three games in the 2005-2020 for Marcus. And he's played in a semi-final and a final. Matthew Wood, Ian Blackwell. Keith Parsons. Don't be shy, boys. Sprint along here, all of you together. Carl Gazzard, the man of the match in the semi-final. Richard Johnson. Charles Langerfeld, the evergreen Andy Caddick. And all the support staff. Keep coming, boys, shift along. And finally, Graeme Smith, the captain, who is also the man of the match. Graeme receives £1,500 cheque and a bottle of Veuve Clicquot champagne for himself. And a cheque for £42,000 for winning the 2020 Cup. You look shattered, but delighted. Would that be fair to sum it up?
Well, I think it's just the pressure, you know. Once that's all gone, you know, you feel relieved. And, sure, man, what a performance by the boys to come and win this trophy. And I think a lot of credit's got to go to our bowlers. As much as we batted to win the title, you know, defending 157 in the first game and knocking over what a strong Lancashire side. Terrific, man.
Yeah, showed a lot of character in that semi-final. Previous Somerset sides might have wilted, but there seems to be a will and a desire to win.
Yeah, it looks that way, and it's great for the future at the club. You know, there's some good key players with some good youth, and, you know, if it's managed right, there can really be a lot of success at the club. And, you know, hopefully for the rest of the season, the boys go and do well. Now I'm going to go and put my feet up for a bit and repair some injuries, and nice way to leave, though.
Yeah, there's some international stars in your side, yourself, Marcus Triscothick, Andy Caddick, but the youngsters have come to the party today. Carl Gazzard in the first game, Hildreth, seeing it home with you at the end there.
Yeah, I mean, it's... It's priceless for their future, you know. Games like this in front of crowds like this, you know, big pressure games, you can only learn from it and take good things from it. And they've played well under immense pressure. And, you know, I think it's good for English cricket.
And what a way for you to finish with Somerset.
Champion, champion.
Well, enjoy the champagne, enjoy the trophy. You need to go back, grab your Man of the Match award and get your hands on that trophy. Graeme Smith, ladies and gentlemen. The Man of the Match, Graeme Smith. Check for £1,500. Plenty of champagne to go round. Somerset are the 2005 2020 champions.
Believed it. Somerset Sabres are the 2020 champions. They only qualified for the quarterfinals as one of the best third-place sides. They won their quarterfinal and they won that well against Northants. They then had an excellent semi-final win against the outgoing champions, the Leicester Foxes. And then in the final, they've gunned down the side that many people thought were absolutely nailed on to win it, the Lancashire Lightning. Lightning did not strike twice today here at the Brit Oval. It's the Sabres that have cut hard and cut deepest. And if anybody says to you that the 2020 competition is just a bit of a hit and giggle and nobody cares about it, A, have a look at the way these boys are celebrating the fact they've won themselves a trophy. And the other thing is you should have just seen the desolation on the Lancashire faces. They were absolutely distraught at having lost that. But this is a moment of celebration for the Somerset Sabres, and in particular for Graeme Smith, who's come over and led the side with such distinction this year. That's his last game of the season. Will he be back? Well, when I asked him that earlier in the week, he said he wasn't sure. He would like to. Don't know whether he will or not, but what a win for Graeme Smith and what a win for the Somerset Sabres. I think they richly deserved it, David.
They've been terrific today and he's led them so well and batted so well, and they're going to miss him.
Well, they are indeed, and Ian Blackwell, of course, now takes over as captain. But let's just analyse why they have won this competition. How come they, with basically a very young side, have managed to down all those international superstars from Lancashire?
Well, they managed to win the competition because they were the one side in the competition that could bowl out Lancashire cheaply. And to beat the best, to be the champions, you have to beat the best. And that's what they did today. They went back to their experienced players, their experienced bowlers, Langeveldt, Caddick and Johnson, because they knew they needed that experience to get past international players. They couldn't leave that to chance. He went back to experience, they didn't let him down. And then the young lads, the keeper, Gazzard, you know, Wood, Hildreth, came to the party with the bat and in the gloves and with the energy. They had a good combination of old and new, and they were well led by that man. And doesn't he deserve all these celebrations? Brilliant effort.
And Robert, you've played against them in the qualifying round. In fact, you beat them in the first game of the season. You should be up there.
We should be champions, you're right. Now, I think the spirit they've shown has been fantastic. As was mentioned earlier, they've scraped their way through into the quarterfinals. They've gained momentum at the right time. I think they got a huge amount of belief from winning the first semi-final. Their spinners did a great job for them there. And then when it came to the final, I think there is a fair bit of luck as well, in as far as the toss was won by Lancashire and they batted first. David Lloyd mentioned it earlier, it was an iffy toss, and then their seam bowlers made a lot of use of the helpful conditions.
Well, there's no luck in it. If you win the toss and decide to bat first, that's your problem.
Yes, definitely, but I think Smith said also that if he'd won the toss, he'd have batted first. So therefore, it's fallen a little bit into their hands, but take nothing away from them. They're a good side, they play hard for each other, and they're going to enjoy tonight.
And I think we can say, can't we, that 2020 is just once again, after another season, on the up and up. That's 3 years and it gets better and better each year.
I think everybody's had a fabulous day. Somerset have thoroughly deserved the win. All the other teams have played their part. We've had a bit of bad weather, but it hasn't mattered. The ground has been full. People have thoroughly enjoyed the day.